Hello students, myself Mahesh M, lecturer in mathematics. I welcome you all, Dr. R.B. Patil Mahesh PU College, Hubballi, Department of Mathematics presents foundation course for PU1 science. Why this foundation course? With the experience of teaching mathematics, we come across some mistakes in mathematics by the students. Some are as below. Here I have listed some of the mistakes done by the students when we were teaching mathematics. Students, with the experience of teaching mathematics to a variety of students over last 5 years, I have an opinion that majority of the students in PUC have some difficulties in certain types of mathematical skills and ability. Any teacher of mathematics would have come across situations to the following ways of answering by the students. Number 1, 4 minus 3 plus 1 equal to 0. Here what students think that 3 plus 1, 4, 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. This is a mistake. Second one, x plus y minus x minus y is equal to 1. Again, it is a mistake. Here, what students think? X, x cancel, y and y cancel. So, the remaining is 1. But the answer is not 1. The answer is 0. Third one, x plus y upon x minus y is equal to 1. Here, the answer is not 1. But students did a mistake. That is 1. 2 plus 4x equal to 6x. It is also a mistake by the student. 2 plus 4x cannot be 6x. It is something like 2 oranges plus 4 apples is equal to 6 apples. Definitely it is not correct. Number 5. 2x plus y upon 3 is equal to x plus 6. Absolutely no way. This is also a mistake. From trigonometry, sine theta upon theta is equal to sin. It seems funny because it is a mistake. Student may have, I can cancel theta theta so that the answer will be sine. Students, these are the just sample mistakes that I have listed here. Like this, students commit mistakes. Why they commit mistakes? The students who commit the above mistake is because of their difficulties in reading a problem, understanding a problem. Such students commit mistakes because of their difficulties in reading a problem, understanding a problem, transferring the words into mathematical procedure. So, these type of mistakes happens. This is what the teacher of mathematics definitely came across in their classes. Then what to do to avoid such mistakes? To avoid these type of mistakes, one must go through basics. That only we call it as foundation course. Many students feel mathematics is difficult to learn, but actually mathematics is not at all difficult. It is fun, beautiful, interesting. Students, I tell you, mathematics is one of the disciplines where there is a largest range of ability. Many students, especially slow learners, we call them slow achievers, describe it as dull, difficult and boring. So, for such students, the bridge course or the foundation course helps students to feel simple, interesting, enjoyable. Let us see some branches of mathematics. What are the main branches of mathematics? Number 1, very important, algebra. Students, don't think algebra is a big cobra, it makes students gabra. No, algebra is a branch of mathematics dealing with symbols and rules for manipulating those symbols. Next branch of mathematics, trigonometry. Trigonometry is a branch of mathematics that studies relationship between side lengths and angles of triangles. The importance of trigonometry is you already studied in your earlier class. Next branch of mathematics, calculus. It is something like backbone of mathematics. After PUC, in every education field, you are going to see this branch of mathematics, that is calculus. Then what is calculus? It is a branch of mathematics, helps us understand changes between values that are related by a function. Students, calculus is used in many different areas such as physics, astronomy, biology, engineering, economics, medicine, sociology. Like this, calculus play an important role in our education field. Then the next branch of mathematics, geometry. Geometry is also a branch of mathematics that studies the size, shapes, positions, angles of dimensions of things, two-dimensional as well as three-dimensional. So these are what the four very important branch of mathematics. Then let us go for the chapters that we have in P1 mathematics so that you can have an idea to prepare yourself about the basic part. Here I have given the list of chapters one by one, you see. Sets, relations and functions, a new chapter for you, depends on set theory. Trigonometric functions, earlier classes you studied trigonometric ratios, that will convert into now trigonometric functions. Principle of mathematical induction. Complex numbers and quadratic equation. You studied up to real numbers. You studied quadratic equation with real roots. Here in this year, you are going to study a new number called complex number, and you will solve the quadratic equation with complex roots. Linear inequalities, permutations and combinations, binomial theorem. Binomial theorem helps to expand the formulas like a plus b to the power 5, also helps to find the middle term or last term in the expansion a plus b to the power 10, etc. Sequence and series. It is also a continuation part of sequence and series that you studied in your earlier class. Straight lines. Here, geometrical part, straight lines helps us to understand the equations of lines in different manner. Conic sections. One of the very important concept in mathematics, conic section. We are going to study some standard curves in this conic sections. Introduction to three-dimensional geometry. The name itself says the introduction. So far you studied two-dimensional geometry. Now in this year, we introduce you three-dimensional geometry. Limits and derivatives. As I discussed, calculus branch, the branch of mathematics, which play an important role in your education field. Therefore, this limits and derivatives is the initiation of calculus branch. Mathematical reasoning. Statistics. Probability. The simple concept that we have probability in P1 mathematics, the basic part already got it in your earlier class. Here also we continue the same, that is probability. My dear students, totally we have 16 chapters in PUC1 mathematics. So once you take the admission into science, you are going to have the four core subjects: physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology. In that mathematics, you are going to see the listed 16 chapters. Then I'm going to take a small concept called number systems. Number system play an important role as a part of basics, because once student very thorough with numbers, they can play easily in this mathematics. Then what is this number system? Number is a fundamental concept of mathematics. The first conception of numbers were acquired by man in remote antiquity. It began with the counting of people, animals and various articles. Students, number system begins when man started counting the things or objects or animals. That time he started giving the invention to the numbers. Then what are the numbers we have? Natural numbers. Why we call them as natural numbers? Students, when you start counting the objects, suppose if you want to count the number of fans in your home, number of cars, number of vehicles, that time we start counting 1, 2, 3, 4. So all these counting numbers are called as natural numbers. The natural numbers are the numbers obtained in the process of counting. They are 1, 2, 3 and it will continue. These are denoted by capital N and the collection. In the collection we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity. Infinity means in Kannada we say Ananta. This flower bracket we used to denote this N is a set. That definition of set you will study in P1 mathematics. It is a collection of counting numbers. Whole numbers. Students, imagine you are solving an equation, say x plus 3 is equal to 3. What is the value of x here? The value of x is going to be 3 minus 3. So x is equal to 0. Then where is this 0? Is this a natural number? No. Then where this 0 comes? So that whole numbers are nothing but natural numbers including 0 are called whole numbers. So what is the reason to establish this 0? To solve or to get the value of x 0, we should have an set that is called whole numbers. So these are denoted by W, the collection of 0, 1, 2, 3. Very simple, students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the natural numbers. To that, there will be one more number, that is 0. So together 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and continues, we call it as the set of whole numbers. At this point, I want to tell you, natural numbers belongs to whole numbers. It means natural number is a subset of whole numbers. Subset, the term subset, you will study in PU1 mathematics in the concept set theory. Then the next number, integers. Again, imagine you started solving an equation, say x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x plus 3 is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 3. Then x is equal to minus 3, where that minus 3 belongs to? Whether it belongs to natural numbers or whole numbers? No way. Minus 3 will not be the natural number. Minus 3 is also not whole number. Then where this minus 3 belongs? So for this, we have the numbers called integers. Corresponding to every natural number A, a new number minus A is created. For every natural number, remember students, for every natural number A, there is a new number called minus A. Suppose 1, minus 1. Suppose 2, minus 2. Suppose 3, minus 3. Like this it will continue. And also remember, there will be 0 also in the integers. Then integers are nothing but positive natural numbers, negative natural numbers and 0. Then these are denoted by capital Z, a collection consisting of these numbers that you can see on the screen. Students, here one very important note I am going to tell you. In this capital Z, we have two types of Z. One is positive integers. That positive integers is denoted by Z plus. If plus is there on the right top of Z, then it is nothing but we are writing positive integers. Z plus is equal to the list of positive integers. You can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It will continue. Only positive integers is nothing but the set of positive integers. Second type of Z. negative integers. Here very simple, on the right top of z there will be minus. So z minus is nothing but negative integers, the set of negative integers. Again you can see the list here, it will continue from this 2, minus 3, and it will continue to minus infinity. So students, this is positive integers and the second one is negative integers. They are denoted as z plus z minus. You can observe carefully note number 192 students, there is 0 in both the set. Then I can call 0 is both positive as well as negative. So 0 is called as neutral number, or 0 is both positive and negative number. Rational numbers. The numbers in the form of P by Q, such that P comma Q belongs to Z and Q is not equal to 0. P by Q, PQ belongs to Z. What it means? Take a number 1 by 2 is in the form of P by Q. So 1 and 2 belongs to Z and 2 is not equal to 0. So this type of numbers are called as rational numbers. For example, 3 by 2, 4 by 5, 7 by 8, all these numbers are rational numbers. And one question, are the natural numbers are rational numbers? Suppose 3, is it a rational number? Yes students, 3 is a rational number, because you can write 3 as 3 by 1, 4 by 1, because you can write in the denominator 1. 5 can be written 5 by 1. So all these type of numbers which are in the form of P by Q are called as rational numbers. Therefore, these are denoted as capital Q, a set of the numbers in the form of P by Q, such that PQ belongs to Z and Q is not equal to 0. After understanding rational numbers, let us go for the king of all numbers, that is real numbers. Students, a real number is defined as finite decimal or infinite decimal, and these are denoted as the set of real numbers are denoted by capital R. Students, I am telling you, real number is nothing but the king of all the numbers. It means that natural number, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, all these numbers are real numbers. Remember, real numbers. Then after understanding all these type of numbers, I can conclude that n is subset, that notation is subset of W. N is subset of W and W is a subset of Z. Z is subset of Q. N is subset of W, W is subset of Z, Z is subset of R. This note I will interpret with some diagram. Before that, let us see one more number, that is irrational numbers. You can ask me why I am giving this irrational numbers after real numbers. Remember students, irrational numbers are real numbers. I repeat, irrational numbers are real numbers, but they are not rational numbers. Then the numbers which are not rational are called irrational numbers. Example, special numbers like pi, root a, where a belongs to real number. Any real number under the root is considered as irrational number. E, the value of e is 2.718. here the value of pi is 3.142. so whenever you want to give the values to some given numbers, that number is going to call as irrational numbers. Then the note that I can tell you here, n is subset of W, n is subset of W, W is subset of Z. These all note I can represent it through one diagram, students, that you can see here. This is a set of real numbers. This is a set of rational numbers. This is a set of integers. This is a set of W, whole numbers, and the set of natural numbers. So students, with this, you just go through this video once again, watch it and feel simple about mathematics, because mathematics is not at all difficult. It is simple. Only it depends on how you react to this subject. So this is what I wanted to discuss in this video about the chapters in PU1 mathematics, as well as a small concept, number systems. In the next video, I'll come with another concept of mathematics. So keep watching our videos. Thank you so much, students. Thank you for watching.